Welcome back to another Smash Ultimate Moveset. It's time for me to cover one of the most recognizable faces in gaming not already in Smash. The first-person shooter genre has seen consistent prevalence in the gaming landscape in the past decades, and while there may not be much representation in the Smash roster, the door is wide open for one of the most iconic FPS characters in gaming history. Master Chief from Microsoft's Halo series. Now I know what you're thinking. John, don't you love Doomslayer and want him in the most? Doesn't making a case for Master Chief conflict with that? Well, it might a little bit, sure, but that's kind of the point. This is a moveset I've wanted to make for a long time, yet every time I came back to it, I could never quite get it right in my head. While I'm constantly tweaking little specifics for Doomslayer's moveset, I could barely lay the groundwork for Chief's. So the point of this video is not only to make a moveset and discuss the content Master Chief could bring to Smash, but also directly compare and contrast him to my vision for Doom Smash representation. I want to make a case for which one I feel should be in Smash Ultimate. But we're getting way ahead of ourselves here. Let's focus back in on John 117 and his franchise. The Halo series started back in 2001 with Halo Combat Evolved, created by Bungie and published by Microsoft as a launch title for the original Xbox. Starring the Spartan super soldier Master Chief fighting the alien Covenant army, its blend of science fiction and mythology took hold immediately, carried by its gameplay and world building. Halo exploded in popularity, being one of the first first-person shooters to really stick the landing on console and led the way for other multiplayer shooters. There have been 15 games in the franchise, most as direct iterations of the main FPS game and a few offshoots like the RTS Halo Wars, and with number 16 coming soon with Halo Infinite, it's safe to say Chief is still in the public eye. When it comes to Master Chief himself, there's nothing too extraordinary about his depth of character. He's mainly a cool, noble soldier with the lives of all of humanity riding on him. And yet, even without a complex background or tons of dramatic baggage, especially in the earlier games, Master Chief has become a cultural icon. Doomguy might have been the first FPS Green Space Marine, but Master Chief is the one everyone knows. With Halo revolutionizing the industry and popularizing entire forms of video making like machinima in the mid-late 2000s. Lastly, for a personal reference point so you know where I'm coming from, I love the Bungie Halo games, and Halo 3 is my all-time favorite game. In my opinion, it's one of the most complete gaming experiences with something amazing for everyone. Now that you know a little bit about Halo and Master Chief, not that you didn't know already, let's start talking about what Chief could be like if he got that Smash invitation in the mail. Spartans and their armor are very heavy, which you can definitely feel in the movement in Halo. Chief is slow and floaty when it comes to FPS heroes, almost completely relying on range to keep himself alive. This would be replicated in Smash, being among the heavier characters of the game, having a slow walk and run speed, and staying pretty floaty. All this combines to make Chief hard to kill, but easy to rack up damage against. While he can pump out tons of damage himself, it would be on Chief to keep opponents at an ideal range to do his best work. Master Chief is a fairly stoic figure in-game, so there wouldn't be too much flashiness to his animations. Not quite as stiff as his in-game model, closer to him in cutscenes. His base stance would be him standing with assault rifle at the ready, then standing more at ease for his idle animation. A little more of his personality would show in his taunts. Up taunt would have Chief take Cortana out from the back of his helmet, have her say something to him or vice versa, and put her back. Side taunt would have him put his AR on his back and look around, and down taunt would have him reload his AR. Visually, anyway, it wouldn't actually do anything, which I'll elaborate on in a sec. You could also stick more fun references in other areas, landing in a drop pod while spawning in, using his flailing death animation for a star KO, and utilizing the classic respawn blips. As for his base appearance and alts, I've chosen to have Chief primarily use his Halo 3 Mark VI armor. I feel it's probably the most iconic and one of the cleanest designs. While you could pull from various elements of Halo for palette swaps, I mainly went the easy way using bright, clear multiplayer colors, along with a special 8th skin harkening back to his Halo CE Mark V armor. Now that we can visualize Master Chief in Smash, let's talk about how he'd actually play. I mentioned earlier that spacing would be crucial to Chief's gameplay. As an FPS icon, it felt important to ensure that the majority of his moves showcase Halo's large arsenal of weapons. While he would have a couple melee attacks, they wouldn't be what his gameplay revolves around. I also briefly touched on the concept of an ammo mechanic. As I've said before in other videos, I'm not a huge fan of mechanics that limit gameplay options. I've seen cool ideas for an ammo mechanic, or a weapon switching, or an energy shield all pulling from Halo, but for this moveset, I'm treating Chief like a versatile yet simple zoner. Let's start working our way through his moves. His jab and nair would be the basic one-hit assault rifle pummel, dealing okay damage and little knockback. It would be a decent tool for getting enemies off you, but not much else. His dash attack would feature the energy sword, specifically the long-range energy sword lunge as a great burst option. The energy sword also appears as the F tilt, though this time weaker and without the lunge, but faster. His other tilts would use more one-handed weapons. A strong but very short range Mauler Blast with up tilt, and forward facing Magnum Fire with down tilt. He would have a neat little mechanic with the Magnum, allowing him to move around while firing single shots. It'd be a good way to rack up a little damage while staying on the move. Moving to grabs next, keeping things smaller scale. Chief would pummel using a one-handed Magnum Strike. Forward throw and up throw both act a little like Falco or Mewtwo's projectile throws, using classic Covenant weapons, an explosive Needler Volley for forward, and a charged Plasma Pistol Stun for up. His back and down throws would use attacks seen in later Halo games, based on his knife-wielding assassinations. His aerials would start to use more powerful weapons, a strong, quick battle rifle burst for fair, a deadly brute shot blade slash for bear, a falling dual SMG volley for up air, and a massive gravity hammer swing for dare. The grav hammer would be his strongest aerial, sending opponents flying while also lifting Chief as a fun extra movement option. Now to move on to his strongest attacks, starting with his smash attacks. This is where we see Chief use his core UNSC weapons. F-Smash is an assault rifle burst similar to Mii Gunner, being a great kill tool with modest range, a bit shorter than Hero's second stage side B. Up Smash would amplify that range greatly with the sniper rifle. Using this move quickly, Master Chief would fire a long-range sniper shot diagonally that covers a ton of ground with a thin hitbox but huge damage. However, while charging this move, you can either click in front of you or behind you to aim straight forward or straight up respectively. And Down Smash would be strongest but shortest with the shotgun. This move would spread from the barrel and do less damage the farther its blast widens, but at the base it could be a very early kill. Now onto his specials, where Chief uses his heaviest artillery. Neutral B would be the Spartan Laser. This power weapon would have a slow charge up but fire a large deadly laser across the stage, similar to Robin's full side B. Timing this right would lead to easy kills, but like I said, you're left pretty vulnerable while charging. Side B would showcase the two main grenades of Halo, tilting for a bouncing frag grenade or smashing for a stronger sticky grenade. Down B would also be an explosive weapon, this being the strongest with the rocket launcher. This combines a little of the first two specials, with quicker long range potential than the laser and a larger blast radius than the grenades. Finally, for his recovery, Up B would use a grav lift, which would be placed or fall under him and have him soar upwards, still able to shoot or jump. Others could use this grav lift until it despawned, similar to spring moves. While a few other things like the jetpack could be used here, I felt that since I'm focusing on Halo 3, I might as well rep the equipment somehow. As for Master Chief's final smash, the most likely would be a Warthog Run cutscene with Arbiter in the gunner seat as the world explodes around them. You could also probably do something like firing a turret out the back of a Pelican, or using other vehicles in general, or maybe a cutscene with the Halo activating and wiping everyone out. I think the Warthog Run is a good callback to the series and a fun representation of a climactic Halo moment. That covers how I think Sakurai would handle Master Chief joining the battle. Like I said, I had a lot of trouble fully finalizing the moveset since there's a lot of places moves could go. I wasn't sure how to handle some of the weapons, and there's also plenty of great movesets out there already that I'd love to see. Regardless, I think I took a safe but hopefully exciting route in envisioning what he'd be like in Smash. Now, what else would he bring with him? As we know, DLC fighters get a classic mode route, a stage, music, spirits, and sometimes Mii costumes. The classic mode is the only thing I don't have a crystal clear idea for. I think you could either recreate different enemies and bosses from Halo, or you could focus on other gunner characters on the roster. For the Halo stage, I went with the central plot point of the whole series by making the stage be based on the ground level of the Halo ring world. You could call this a few things: Halo, Installation 00, the Ark, Valhalla. Either way, just have that big green world with cool sci-fi structures and the ring on the horizon. If you wanted to mix it up more, you could have a Covenant ship come by and beam you up, and add classic Halo enemies and vehicles as hazards. And these are the songs I've chosen to come with it. There's so many options from the main games, but I tried to cut it down to a reasonable number, mainly by cutting songs that repeated the same musical ideas. Newer Halo games get a little more music because they changed it up more. Going into spirits, there's a plethora of friendly characters and alien enemies that are all worthy of lesser lesser Smash representation. I tried to keep it to a fairly small number as the other DLC do, so it's only the biggest name characters and classic enemies. Two fighter spirits for Master Chief with his two different armors, a grunt novice support spirit portrayed by Diddy Kong, a jackal novice support spirit portrayed by Falco, a brute advanced grab spirit portrayed by Donkey Kong, an elite advanced attack spirit portrayed by Ridley, a Cortana advanced support spirit portrayed by Zero Suit Samus, a guilty spark advanced defense spirit portrayed by a small Rob, a Hunter Ace Attack Spirit portrayed by K-Rool, a Sergeant Johnson Ace Neutral Spirit portrayed by Snake, an Arbiter Legend Attack Spirit portrayed by Ridley again, and a Noble Team Legend Neutral Spirit portrayed by 5 Master Chiefs with different items or focused attacks. Finally, for me costumes, I could see an Elite or Arbiter Swordsman with an Energy Sword, and a Gunner either based on a Noble Team Spartan or ODST. Now that we know everything Chief could bring to the game, we have to ask what the odds are that any of this could happen. Before Smash Ultimate and the DLC, most people would have said there was no chance. Nintendo and Microsoft were competitors, there's no way Microsoft would let them use their mascot. But now the walls have come down a bit. Microsoft has put multiple huge games on Switch, and even helped finally bring Banjo into the roster. Clearly, their relationship has changed in a beneficial way to everyone. So nowadays, I think he has okay chances. The fame and impact of the Halo brand, Master Chief's icon status, and the space for an FPS rep on the roster all bode very well for Chief, along with Nintendo and Microsoft's collaborations and the fact that Microsoft is already in Smash. Plus, despite Halo being a fairly violent game, it could be toned down very easily. The main speed bumps for Chief's inclusion come from other potential FPS reps, which I'll talk about in a minute, the use of guns in the entirety of his moveset, and the overall tiny number of Western characters getting into Smash. If another Western franchise gets in through DLC, will it be Halo and Chief, or was Banjo more of a one-time deal to satisfy longtime fan requests? Only time will tell, but on the whole, I'd say Chief has a 50-50 shot. But let's go back to the question of FPS representation in Smash. While it's not necessary that Smash fills this niche, it's an entire toolset of gameplay that could lend itself to a very unique moveset, something Sakurai is looking for now more than ever in the DLC. There's characters like Gordon Freeman from Half-Life, Heavy from Team Fortress 2, Tracer from Overwatch, and many, many more that could all be considered. Undoubtedly though, Master Chief is one of the biggest FPS names of all. But how does he compare to the other biggest FPS ever? Halo might be one of the biggest FPSs out there, but Doom is the father of the genre. More importantly, Doom has had a massive resurgence into the mainstream in the past years, with id and Bethesda's Doom 2016 and Doom Eternal. The same can be said about the main character of those games, the player-controlled Doom Slayer. The newer games have gone to great lengths to characterize the Slayer with more expression, more backstory, and most importantly, embodying demon-killing rage. Both Doom and Halo have every right to get their green soldier guy into Smash, but which do I think should? Well, now that I've gone over Master Chief, I feel I have a good grasp on what both could bring to the table. Let's put them head-to-head and see which franchise wins the invitation. First, we'll talk about the two series' impact on gamers and gaming history. Smash is not only an amazingly fun fighting game, but frequently serves as the way to highlight some of the industry's most important faces. Like I said, the Doom series is the reason the first-person shooter genre is as big as it is today. Without Doom, there probably wouldn't be Halo. It might not have been the first, but it was the game that put the genre on the map and is still very important and remembered fondly today, in both the new and old games. As for Halo, it was the franchise that finally made console FPSs as big as they are now. Some of the biggest modern FPS games wouldn't have succeeded as much as they did without Halo paving the way, and Halo truly did own the 2000s. However, I'm giving Doom Slayer the point here for a few reasons. Doom is the classic FPS, making for great representation. The Halo series has not been going as strong recently compared to Doom, and on a more business history side, Nintendo and Bethesda have been working very well together recently. Sure, they've been working with Microsoft too, but Bethesda getting some of their biggest games onto Switch early in the console's life was a big deal. I think if it came down to it, they would be easier to communicate with than Microsoft, so point for Doom. Moving on, let's talk about the characters' appearances in the Smash style. Both are armor-clad soldiers wielding semi-realistic firearms that function from the first-person view, meaning they should be pretty similar, right? Nope. Master Chief, as stated earlier, is pretty stoic and collected even in cutscenes. Sometimes he bursts into action a little more, but he's not very expressive. Meanwhile, Doomslayer's violent personality has been put front and center recently, giving him extremely dynamic movement and attacks. His armor has also been made a little more vibrant and interesting in Doom Eternal, along with offering a wide range of palette swap options, including his iconic and cartoony original Doomguy armor. Easy point for Doom here. Now for stages, further representing the whole world of the games. Like I said, Master Chief's Halo stage would bring in the rich, beautiful world of the series and has the potential to reference awesome vehicles and alien environments. Doom has a few options, equally alien in nature. A dusty orange Mars base, overrun UAC construct, or a stage set in Hell. The Hell stage has the most potential, being dark and fiery and full of evil energy, unlike anything we've seen in Smash, allowing for classic enemies to feature as well. But here's where we run into the main problem with Doom. While the Slayer himself can be toned down to be less violent, the world of Doom makes that much harder. I'm not sure how much of the demonic angle they can really push, especially when it comes to setting a stage in Hell or equally bloody location. If they went the safe option with a Mars UAC base, I'm not sure how well that would represent Doom. Therefore, because it's a safer, clearer option, Halo gets the stage point. These stages would of course both come with music. Doom would bring the Smash soundtrack to a new level of heaviness, with absurdly brutal metal tracks that would be amazing to jam to. I'd also love to hear some remixes of older Doom songs. These are the songs I'd like to hear. You could probably trim the newer stuff a little bit if you wanted more of the old music. On the other hand, Halo brings not only some great percussion-driven orchestral tunes, but one of the best theme songs ever. Hearing the Halo theme in Smash alone would be mind-blowing. I personally lean towards Doom music, but both are so strong that they each get a point. Outside of stages and music, both characters would bring in some amazing spirit and costume options. I've gone over the Halo ones already, but never really talked about Doom's outside of Twitter. I'll throw my choices on screen. Outside of a few plot-important characters, these are mainly reserved for Doom's memorable demons. Costumes could be simple hats like the long-ago rumored Kako Demon hat, or full costumes like the classic Doomguy armor or Bethesda costumes from series like Fallout and Skyrim. Again, because of the potential trouble getting the demonic and violent imagery into the game, and for the sheer awesomeness of a Mii Swordfighter with the energy sword, the point goes to Halo. Well, we're all tied up. Only the most important category left. At the end of the day, the moveset is the most important factor in a character's inclusion in Smash. Sakurai has said many, many times how critical finding a unique gameplay angle is for a new fighter. All the other content and the star power is great, but it's not what gets a character in or leaves them out. Both of these characters are ranged focused, using guns for most of their moves and close range brutality for things like their grabs and throws. They both have machine guns, shotguns, and energy powered super weapons. But if I'm trying to put my bias aside, I do truly think Doomslayer wins this one. Master Chief has a chance to just be a traditional zoner, with gameplay we've seen from characters like Samus, Snake, and Mega Man already. He's slow, floaty, and relies on keeping opponents away, all things not generally liked by Smash players. But Doomslayer's hyper-aggro playstyle fits perfectly with the gunplay. Instead of keeping enemies away, you'd be charging in constantly, melting them with attacks. Doom is all about fast movement, getting in faces, and offense over defense. And that's why I think Doomslayer would be more interesting to play than Master Chief. Although I've given Doomslayer the win in this head-to-head, I do want to make it clear that I'd love either of these characters, and both would bring a lot to Smash. I wouldn't have finally made a Master Chief moveset if I thought he didn't offer anything fun to the game. Halo is one of the most important and influential franchises to me, so seeing it represented in Smash would really make it perfect. What do you think? Do you think Chief would fit into the Smash roster? Are there ways you would change my moveset? Do you think Master Chief or Doomslayer is better, or do you think shooter characters wouldn't work in Smash? Let me know in the comments. This is the last big solo moveset I have planned at the moment, but I'm starting to rebuild my list of possibilities and I'm still working on Ready Moveset Go, so don't worry, more will be coming soon. Until then, please subscribe, check out my other movesets, and thanks for watching.